Okay then, here it is, the last video. Cahua 1 was a disappointment. We only got 50% of the secrets, so we missed 2 just like in Ostok 1. Again, I feel really stupid after looking at the secret guide, but sure, anyway. Look, here we go, it's time for Cahua 2, and I know where all the secrets are here, so we're in for an easy ride for this last video. Yeah, we got really long hauls to go through, which make us wish we still had the vehicle. Oh, damn it. Yeah, could spend ages going up and down this hall, but mercifully I already know that there are no secrets here. So, yeah. Yeah, we just have to bring the ball close to these doors and they open. I think that's it. Yep. Damn. Loads of mines. Okay, the mummies will destroy themselves. Or not, to be quicker to just do it this way. The traditional way, as one might say. This let's play has taken so long that it feels like I've been playing for ages, so traditional is a not unreasonable way to put this. And a train, just like back in Ostok 1 and the beginning of Ostok 2. And the usual fiddly bit, actually trying to get the ball into the right position. Damn it! There we go. Alright, so you stop attracting the ball as soon as it's up on it. Oh, okay, that makes sense. Total okay. Ah, well. Has the music stopped? Oh no, yeah, the music had stopped, but now it started again. Combat music. Okay, here we go. I see. Yep. Ah, for God's sake. Right, so I'm back here now. Nice. I get the idea. Just got an achievement, that's one I wasn't even looking for, but anyway. Excellent. Damn it, the combat music isn't playing properly. Ah, for God's sake, will you get in there? It's like playing flippin' golf. Like Donald Trump and Bill Clinton. Oh dear, naughty me, I just got political again. Come on. Actually, yeah. Mortal, okay. Right, how do I do this? How do I skin this cat, as one might say? Just like what the secrets are normally perched upon. Looks good. On. Progress is lost, they're just as injured as they were a minute ago. This is really awkward. Ah, I see. Okay, so moving on to the next batch of puzzles. I'll tell you what this reminds me of. This section vaguely reminds me of the beginning of Half-Life 2 Episode 1 with the Citadel blowing up. Now. Secret number one. Ishtilton even. I am the son of Quetzalcoatl. What lies here is the ruin of my empire. Let it be known that we were once great and favored amongst all others in the eyes of the gods. Let it be known that they gave us a gift that made us mighty, made us sovereign. That we walked this world and made all we touched a kingdom of gold. May all who find us remember and beware. Midas. You know, all we touched, gold. Be careful what you wish for, and all that. Come on. That's not the right way to get up there, is it? It is. God, I love this music. Omakat. The ball hums as the smog from the last flame of war lingers and dies. From the moment it was taken, our fate was sealed. The blasphemers sought to make it so that the ball could never be recovered by the God King's armies, amassing their wisest inventors to seal the kingdom from within. These walls are a mechanical tomb, and the ball is its cipher. So, yeah. So they're the ones responsible for all these puzzles. And yet, the Tlaloke are clearly... they're sort of built into some of the puzzles, and yet they're the guards of the factory. They had nothing to do with the so-called blasphemers. I don't know, it's... tis a bit vague, but sure. Yeah. Mummies. Wait, was one of those wearing a crown? Was one of them Ishtilton himself? I don't know. No. Reading too much into it now. And... oil and fire. Another mechanic we haven't seen since Ostok 1. So yeah, we... basically... paint the ground with loads of oil, and then... and then we don't do that! Okay. So I messed that up. Come on, why is it drying up? Okay. I can't help but feel I'm going the wrong way about this. If I do it this way, send it down there. Okay, yeah, that was quite effective. Okay, now we're talking. Excellent. Yes. Now then. More mummies. So we have the oil where we need it. Come on! For Pete's sake! You bleeding flogging. How come when I go in here it stops the combat music? Oh. Ah, hey. Lit up the torch without actually seeing it, but there you go. See, it's lit up in there, and that's opened the next place we need to go to. No. Now you can see there's something in here. So, yeah, I spent ages once trying to walk up these things and jump on the ball and maybe get through the door. It's not possible, trust me. What you have to do is be more observant. Something I failed to do, I had to look up a secret guide, but that's how you get in. No. I know these flipping mines. Now, here we go. Sipak Tonal. Pretty sure we met him already. We took the ball from them, the source of their mysterious power. Echoing the very first, the very first inscription in the whole game. From the sanctum of the forbidden place, we removed the giver of gifts and stole it for ourselves. We were arrogant and we were wrong. It must be brought back to them. We must make right what has been done for the sake of our souls and the souls of our children. Yeah. Well, guess what? It's finally happening. After hundreds, if not thousands of years, the ball is being brought back to the sanctum. Yeah, it feels right bringing it back, I think. And the ball's getting excited. This would be the forbidden place. That's behind me now, here we go. The forbidden place. And this is the ball's final resting place. Thank you. Now then. Right, so that's the ball's final resting place. Well, or not, as we'll see shortly. Now, this player button is now uncovered. And it starts closing these doors really slowly. Right, so as it happens, we can go in here. There's a handy little gas fire. Look, little pilot light and everything. Oh no, they all have crowns. They all have crowns in here. Yes, the only mummies who would be left in here would be the people who are loyal to the Ishtilton. Oh wait, these ones don't have crowns. The plot thickens. Pity it's almost over. Now. Right. No, fairly simple task left. I have to read this sequence of Mayan numerals. So I can never remember if it's horizontal or vertical, so we'll try vertical first. 1, 3, 4. Are the first three. One, three, we're right, four. Okay, so yeah, the people who sealed the place even had the cheek to stick these yokes that have to be pushed up. I'm wondering who put in the gas fire though. Seems rather a strange thing to have in a volcano. Seven, nine, five. Yeah. Gotta admire the Mayan numeral system. I don't know. It's quite like the Roman numeral system. But why wouldn't it be? It's just a numeral system. Okay. Eight, 2. Six, and the moment of judgment arrives as we get to 10. Stuff is about to get real. Ball electrified, turns blue. Interesting. Here comes the king. What's he at? No sign of Spebbington, of course. Should be able to see him on top of the flying saucer.
To better the tribes of man. To care for man as he was meant to care for all the creeds of the earth. But man had his own intentions. After the war, the survivors escaped with their wisdoms and repopulated the globe. Of this baptism of fire, man's children would live to spread contradictions and mysticism.
Oh well. Wow. And the king's being very nice. He's giving us a chance to get off. Turns out he's not such an evil chap after all. Now, down we get. Secrets found. Yeah, half an hour. I knew it. On average, these levels seem to take number of secrets required to find multiplied by 10 minutes. And as I say, it is the only exception being Pewa, and of course that path over there leads back to Pewa. Yeah, this door's the door we couldn't get through at the very start. And then, look, there's...
Hey! Good to see you again! I hope you had an interesting time down there!
Oh, you bet!
The new crane just got here! We're coming down now!
Oh, well. Short. Anyway, sure, I missed 4 of the secrets. Oh well. Pity. Just let the credits run. Oh, and the Ostok music starts up again. The de facto main theme, I guess. Yep. So that's the end of that. I did say that afterwards I'd sort of start talking about the game's sequel and all that. Well, I don't know. Look, I don't know, there seemed to be a moral to the story. Like, we shouldn't pretend that people, it seemed to be a fairly clear-cut case of people pretending they were above other people and that all leading to chaos and tragedy, but... Yeah, and that's a good moral to take away from it, but, even in this day and age. But still, so if I may talk about the sequel now, the Solus Project, well, in that it seems that the aliens themselves are guilty of that they enslaved another race and definitely enslaved them and did experiments on them, so it turns out they may actually have encouraged certain people to position themselves above other people in this Aztec society or whatever it is. So yeah, suddenly the moral isn't so clear-cut. And of course the other thing, at the very start I said I'm glad the ball didn't break when it fell several kilometers. That's because it turns out in the Solus Project that these balls, there's more than one, they actually have smoke monsters inside, and if they break, the smoke monster comes out and kills whoever broke it. Yeah. Well, sure. The skulls are sort of a clue that the thing is dangerous. And most of them don't have any symbols carved in them either, so... obviously the humans did that. They went crazy. And, yeah, suggestions that the aliens themselves don't actually understand the ball either, they just got the information from even more ancient aliens, which is kind of a cop-out really, but anyway, I don't know. I think the ball stands on its own very much, I mean the game, not the object. It stands on its own fairly well, but the sequel sort of muddies the waters a bit. I don't know, maybe I'm looking at it the wrong way. Okay. So, missed four secrets. Yeah, I could do a let's play of the Solus Project. On my first playthrough I said some things that were sort of let's play worthy, but I don't think I could replicate it because, you know, the spontaneity would be gone. And I can't get all secrets. Because it's nearly impossible. They don't call the achievement God Almighty for nothing. There's also the extra level in the ball called Quizás. The developers call it Quizás, but anyway, I can see why. I don't think I'll do a let's play of that either, because I've already played through it once and I know where everything is. So again, there'd be no spontaneity or anything like that. Anyway, so if you've watched for this long, I think I can let you in on a little secret. No pun intended. I first got the idea to do this playthrough as sort of a practice run. I was thinking of digging out Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, and trying to figure out if it was possible to get all 40 silver wizarding cards. Because there's sort of a similarity between finding those and finding the secrets here, but of course that game's non-linear, which could make it easier or harder, I don't know. But I don't think I'll make a let's play of it, because as I say, the game's non-linear, and it's been years since I've touched it, and to be honest, I don't even know if I'm gonna do it, but yeah. But no, I've enjoyed doing this, even if I didn't end up getting all the secrets. At least I got well over half of them this time, and I unlocked that achievement for rolling the ball just there, which was a nice bonus. See, there we go, there, and yeah, 31 of 35, and what's the other one, this one, 100 kilometers. That's aggregated over all my playthroughs, I assume. Anyway, so that's the end of it.